Hey, gang, here we are again. This is Andy at the Facebook Live TV show, and we're going to interview a few more authors who have become number one best-selling authors. Now, just to refresh your memories, we're here in San Diego creating best-selling authors in 3 days. We did this in 3 days. There were about 100 people that attended, and we had 100% success rate, which is crazy. And this is one of our authors here who I worked with almost every day in some form or fashion, because I'm one of the certified consultants that helped bring these people to number one best-selling status. And first of all, tell us your name, probably because I can't pronounce it, and the name of your book and what we can find inside your book. So go ahead.
Okay. Hi, my name is Maëlys Gatimel. I work as a consultant. I work on happiness at work. I hate to see people suffering at work, because we spend so much time working, so it's better to be happy. And so the book is Be the Best Boss. And I come from New Caledonia, which is a small French island close to Australia. And I came all the way here because I thought it was very interesting, and the program was very interesting. I think I slept 3 or 4 hours last night. We worked a lot, it was a lot of fun, and I learned a lot too. And I can believe I'm a bestseller author in the US, but also 3 times in France, which is not bad.
Yeah. Wow, you know, I didn't think to send a couple people, to the France Amazon, because obviously you're from France and we're purchasing people's books, right?
Yeah, and some of my friends bought the book in France, and I checked, and it's number one in the 3 categories. So
can you tell us what's your history with this subject that you're able to write a book about it?
Okay, I've been working for 25 years improving relationships at work. First, I was working on quality of service, and I work as a consultant for companies like Arthur Anderson and PricewaterhouseCoopers. I was a manager expert in quality of service, but when you implement a program, how do you make sure that people will follow in the time, like it will last? So I had a very intensive training on how you get people so that they're willing to change and have better relationships. So in fact, it's a lot of details. It's sometimes it could look simple, but it's usually we have a social audit or work relationship audit. And we do it the old-fashioned way, because we think that people don't trust computers. They would write. I'm sorry for the word, but they would write on a computer, My boss is a jerk, or my boss is a whatever asshole. So we have to do them. We have them to do it on paper, that the old-fashioned way. But that this way we get what people really think about their company. And it's very valuable information for the boss. And then we put together a plan, action plan, with everything we had to implement.
Well, one thing I got to talk to you about, you got to scoot closer. You're now going to be famous because you're a number one best-selling author. You're going to be interviewed. One thing you got to get used to is that the mic comes very close to your mouth. And what's happening is you're backing up. And so I'm chasing you. So you got to get used to being...
I learned something.
Be really close to your mouth. Yeah, really important. Really important.
I need to say that Andy has been very helpful. I had to fight with all the computer stuff, Amazon stuff, and he's been great. Thank you, Andy.
Oh, you're very welcome. So what is one of the things you're going to do with your book now that you're number one best-selling author? What are your plans with the book? Do you want to speak on stage? Do you want to get on television? What are the plans?
I'd love to speak on stage. I do it already, but I think it's a very good way to get it. And I'm sorry to say to a man, but in our country, it's very macho. Yeah. So with my book, I can get on the local television a lot easier.
So you're saying where your country, they're macho, but in the United States, not so much?
I think there's enough room for women, for business women in the U.S., yes. There are a lot of successful women in the U.S. I went to Lisa Sasevich training too, and there are quite a lot of successful women in the U.S. In our countries, like when you start, you have to prove all the time, a lot more, I guess.
Well, good luck with everything. It was really nice meeting you, and I really appreciate your patience with me as I was teaching you how to be a number one best-selling author. It was awesome. You're very welcome. It has been fantastic here. You can hear all the noise. People are cheering. We have a few libations, as Mike Koenigs would say, and I was looking for a couple other people that I promised to interview. Where did they go? I lost them. Hello. I know that John North is on from Australia. I think he's still on. Yep, Mr. John North. Hello. I see that you joined. That's okay. Where did they go? I got Melody over there. Caroline. We have so many different offers that I wanted to find out. Oh, here it is. Here she is. Hold on. Hold on. I'm going to go out for camera for a second. Can I interview you? All right. We have sex therapists. We have, of course, coaches, business coaches. You're one of my sex therapists. Is that okay to say?
No, I'm a sex coach.
Oh, sex coach. I got to ask now, what's the difference between a sex coach and a sex therapist?
Well, sex therapist will help people really more with their individual issues, but a sex coach will teach them a process for gaining more pleasure.
Oh.
And we also say, go raw team.
Awesome. Okay, so now let's go back, because I had to find out right away or else I would have forgot. Who are you? Give everybody your name. Give them the name of your book and what they can find inside your book.
My name is Andrea Woodward. I'm from Santa Barbara, California. And my book is called Bringing Your Sexy Back, How to Get your Deepest Sexual Desires Out of Your Head and Into Your Lover's Touch. And yeah, this book is going to bring all kinds of pleasure to the world. So the thing is that people often have a hard time talking about sex and talking about what they desire. And in fact, sometimes they don't even know what it is they desire. So this book will take them through a process to examine what it is that inner voice really wants. And then we'll learn the techniques for saying it effectively so that your lover can hear it.
Yeah, I cannot wait to read this book, because it sounds like I could have used this in a couple of relationships that I had.
Well, absolutely. We all could learn more skills and techniques, but the end result will be a greater likelihood that you will have the kind of sexual experience that you really desire.
Even in those cases where the women feel slightly different because of giving childbirth, I know that's an issue that is spoken about a lot, that once they have kids, there's something that changes either in the man. Or the woman, is it addressed that type of issue also?
Well, there are a couple things. As you said, sometimes it's the man who changes in his perspective at how he looks at his sex partner. But for women, the change is not only physical, but also emotional, and that feeling of connection, and that's where the energy is going. It's taking care of young children. And so in this process, we'll learn to give ourselves time to come back to being able to really look for our own desire, our own pleasure. And so, and also to recognize that these are just phases in a person's life.
Well, that's good to know. I want to go back to the book writing process just a little bit, since we're talking about becoming a number one best-selling author, that kind of stuff. We had a chance to sit down and talk about book titles, and you had a previous book title and subtitle. You know, one of the things is who does the title speak to when people are looking for a book and that kind of stuff? How did you come up with that title and the subtitle for your audience? What was the important things that they needed to hear or see?
Well, they really need to know what it is they're going to get in the book. They need to know that this book is for them. And so it was really essential that I come up with a title that would actually speak to them about being able to speak about their sexual desire. And I want to do it with a light-handed touch, because sex is so often a topic that we're nervous about, even terrified, especially when it comes to talking to our own partners. So I wanted to be able to address it in really a light-handed and even humorous way.
And we talked about you had the word hand in that first subtitle,
right.
And we discussed that sometimes hand has to do with grabbing and groping,
right,
where we
right.
wanted to be more of a touch, and that's how we came up with that testing, which seems to be a little bit more soft and gentle, which I'm going to have to go off here.
Yeah, that's absolutely right.
So go buy the book. It's called
Getting Your Sexy Back.
All right. So go get the book, 99 cents, change your sex life forever. All right. Love you guys. I'll see you later. Thanks.